Getting the colours right on your photographs is obviously of paramount importance to you as a photographer, because that's how you present your art. Darktable has a whole suite of colour manipulation tools, and one of them is called colorcorrection. In this video, we're going to look at how it works and what it does. Hi, and welcome to episode 41 of Understanding Darktable. So, the colorcorrection module. It does pretty much as the name would suggest. Let's dive on in and have a look. Last weekend, I did a quick studio shoot with this young lady, Sibylla. She's the daughter of a good friend of mine. And I thought I would just use this image as the guinea pig for this particular video. As you can see, all I've done is gone right back to the original. So I've undone all of the default stuff that Darktable does. And I've just applied a very basic tone curve to stretch the histogram. That's pretty much all I've done. Okay, so looking at the color correction module, if we switch it on, what we've got is this little white dot in the middle of the graph. And if you feel that the tones or the colors in your image need to be warmer or cooler or whatever, it is simply a case of left click on that dot and drag it in the direction you want to go. So if you decided that the skin tones here were maybe too warm or a little bit too yellow, you would essentially just move in the opposite direction. So I can just click and drag, and the further I go, the more intense that color shift becomes. Now, I don't want to end up looking like a smurf, but maybe somewhere around there feels a little more natural in terms of skin tone. Again, no hard and fast rules here. All comes down to your interpretation, your aesthetic for your images. Now, the problem here, of course, is that I've shifted the white background towards blue, so I could then introduce either a drawn mask or a parametric mask or both. Let's maybe just go with a drawn mask for now. And I will be very quick and rough with this. Just something like that, and like so. Let's have a look at where we've got to. Let's just feather this out so it's nice and soft on the edges. That should do us. And we've now excluded our background from this color correction, but we've cooled down her skin tones, and we can check that just by toggling the module on and off. Okay, so that's our starting point. The next thing to note is the saturation slider. There are at least three ways we can work with the saturation control. One is to left click and drag, like so. Next is to right click and enter a value, like so. The third is to simply mouse over this color swatch and use your mouse wheel. And as you roll your mouse wheel away from you, you are increasing saturation. As you roll your mouse wheel back towards you, you are decreasing saturation. A saturation value of 1 is essentially the starting point. It's not 0, it's 1. Any value below 1 is desaturating your image. So you'll notice that as we keep winding this back, our image is becoming less and less saturated. And you'll notice that the color swatch is becoming desaturated as well. And this works all the way down to 0, where we end up with a monochrome image. But then we can go to negative values. And what this is doing is essentially inverting the color information. So all of our things that were red have now become blue, and all of our things that were blue have now become red. And again, the further we take that slider, the more extreme things get. And we do end up with her looking like a smurf. Let's have a look at some of the default presets. We've got a cooling filter. Now, as you can see with this, the black dot is actually not starting right in the center of the graph. And that's one thing I hadn't mentioned, is once you've dragged your white point to some other spot in the graph because you want to shift your colors in that particular direction, You can then also move the black point. I'm not sure why you would do this. Maybe if you had a, you know, really old photographic print that you'd scanned where the colors had faded abnormally and were really out of whack, you might have a need to do something like that. To be honest, I've never encountered an image where I've needed to move the black point. I've generally always left it smack bang in the middle and just used the white point to drag all of my colors in one particular direction. We've then got a warm tone. Okay, that makes it look yellow. We've got a warming filter. And then we've got some mono to soft sepia, strong sepia. So these assume that you're working with a monochromatic image. So what we'll do is we'll just reset this, turn this module off, and I'll use my little preset in the color zones module that I set for my black and white starting point. So now we can go black and white mono to soft sepia, and we get a nice soft sepia approach. We can try the strong sepia. Yeah, nice. So this is another way of achieving what I was talking about in the split toning video, where, you know, I love my black and white, but I don't always want it to just be shades of grey. Sometimes I want to introduce a little bit of a colour cast just to give it some character. This is another way of doing just that. Now, you'll notice that the saturation is at 1, and I mentioned if you wanted to desaturate, you had to have the saturation set to 0. This is not the case in this instance because we've already got a monochrome image before we came into the color correction module. If you tried to do it all in the color correction module by setting saturation to 0, you then wouldn't be able to introduce any color cast at all. Just to demonstrate that, I will go back prior to the color zones. We'll turn this on and we'll set this to 0. And you'll then see that no matter where we drag our white point, we don't introduce any color because we've completely desaturated the image using this saturation control. If for some bizarre reason you wanted to use the color correction module to create your monochrome image, and then you wanted to introduce that sepia tone, you would need to introduce a second instance of the module. So you could do what we've done here, which is to simply set saturation to 0. We could then click on duplicate instance, or use your middle mouse button on this button here, and that will create a new color correction module, which we should then rename to sepia, and then you could use the preset, and there you go. You've achieved the same thing using two instances of the color correction module. And that pretty much does it for the color correction module. There's really not a whole lot else to say. If you have ways of using it that I haven't covered, then please sing out in the comments down below and share your experiences with other subscribers. And I will see you in the next one.